So, the countdown has begun, and we're going to get straight into it as soon as the game has loaded and all that good stuff. But first map's going to be GSL Belshire Beach Winter Edition, so it's going to be interesting here. I don't think a lot of Zergs... Actually, you know what? I'm going to take that back. I think Zergs are starting to like the map a bit more now.
Yeah, I think like any map, the more you play on it, the more you kind of work out the ins and outs of the map, what you can abuse, what sucks for you, and likewise for Terran. So let's quickly introduce the players, and we can talk about that a little bit more, maybe.
Yeah, definitely. Down here, bottom right on the GSL's Belshire Beach Winter Edition, it is going to be our Red Terran, Zero Gaming's Iaguz, and his opponent's going to be the one, the only mOOnGLade up here in the top left as our Purple Zerg. Still got a hunch this is NVIDIA's Zerg player. It just has to be. Who else can it be? It's just... Oh, yeah. Man, it has to be. But speculation's going all over the shop, but... yeah. So, what are your predictions for Game 1? What do you reckon?
You know what? I haven't seen that much TvZ on this map, so I'm not entirely sure what goes on. For the most part, though, because most of what I've seen on this map has come from GSL, and I've seen a lot of Terrans win on this map because... the bases past your natural a little bit trickier to defend. If a Terran sieges up outside your natural, that cuts you off from the rest of the map. That's it. You can't get out. There's no other ramps on this map, unlike the original Belshire match map. And even once you secure your third, you know, that fourth is still a little bit out of the way. And anything past that, you know, it's a lot more exposed. But you know, likewise for the Terran. And there's a lot of places on this map where you can counterattack. If the force is just too big, you don't want to engage it for whatever reason, you can try and run into the natural, try and run into the main. So there's lots of possibilities that way as well.
I just want to quickly point out that there is a smiley face in the natural. I don't know how I didn't see that. Get a little two flowers as the eyes and the blue minerals as the mouth.
You're right.
There you go.
Oh well, that's cute.
So it looks like Iaguz is going to go for the gas off to the barracks, getting a nice wall in here. This is Belshire Beach, and you can wall it in with a single depot and a single rack, so that's a slight advantage for Terran, I guess, against any race, really. But, I mean, Zergs know what Terrans do in the opener, so it's not too much of an issue.
Yeah.
I mean, there could be crazy stuff hidden behind, like six racks all in or something like that. But, you know, Zerg's going to keep a ling or so at the base and see if there's any sort of SCV trains or anything crazy like that coming at your way. So, I mean, it's not that much of an issue, but, I mean, hey... It's, you know, it's denying information from your opponent when they would like to at least see the gas can, I guess. Probably the big thing Zergs are looking for with that early scout.
And really nice bunker positioning from Iaguz here. Glade can't actually see that just yet. He just sees it now because he did bring his overlord back, seeing that SCV creep in there. So this bunker is actually very, very close to finishing though already, but he's pulling forward drones, making sure he takes it seriously. But if he gets unlucky, that SCV could stay untouched for quite a bit longer. Will he finish it? Looks like he will. And that bunker goes up. Where is the first Marine? Here it comes. Will Glade be able to stop it from getting in there?
Wow, he actually just going to let it slip in there, and the first Marine hits inside that bunker, and that bunker is in range of the hatchery, so it will take fire, and the second Marine waltzing his way over there to meet his buddy, and will sit in that bunker until they eventually die. So I guess they probably cuddled each other, hugging each other, but it looks like there's going to be a reactor Hellion following up, coming out for Iaguz as well behind this, getting a second Rax as well, so not a quick command center, instead opting to go for a quicker second Rax, so he might have changed his gameplay a bit, perhaps, with his bunker.
Yeah.
But, I mean, mOOnGLade's going up to take it out, so I don't know.
Yep, we'll see what he wants to do with this. Probably going for a little bit heavier pressure than... is he going to go Marauder Hellion? Yeah, he's going to go Marauder Hellion. Possibly even bring some SCVs, I might say, for this sort of thing. And of course, Glade can't really scout this, and with this bunker, it's going to be really annoying. Glade can't mine from that base, and he doesn't really want to overmake stuff to kill it, but unfortunately he's made quite a few lings already, and it's only two Marines in there, so I don't think he needs to make quite as many lings as he did. but yeah, I guess unfortunately not getting the salvage there. But yes, Marines will die as well, but Hellions are out now, and there's only slow lings, although I guess he's kind of backed himself into a corner here, and he will lose these first two. Okay, he loses at least one, but I think that one will go down as well.
Eventually.
Yeah.
There we go. Speed kicks in, so he manages to sneak it out. And two more Hellions just going to sit here. No, actually, they're going to retreat. But, yeah, it's going to be all tails, science. Well, that made no sense either. God, I suck at speaking today. I don't know what's going on. All science lead to Marauder Hellion, is basically what I was trying to say. He's got two racks, though, for double Marauder production. So, he's gone really heavy into this. And, I mean, Glade isn't even throwing down a... Oh, okay, I speak too soon. There is a single spine crawl going down, but, you know, one spine's not going to be enough for a Marauder Hellion push. I mean, a single spine crawl defense is usually what prompts this kind of aggression. And, I mean, if it was something else that prompted this aggression, it looks like, no, it's going to be an Evo Chamber to help with the wall off, but... if those wings got into the main, we might have seen a repeat. But, no, it looks like it's going to be alright. We'll snipe a few Hellions, forcing the others to retreat, but these links look like they're going to die. Inevitably. Oh, they're actually going to sneak out? Nope.
You know, Glade's actually made a lot of links in the early game here, and he's still making more. He has 10 out on the map once again now, and he has, 24 drones only. Okay, he's got 27 now, but here comes the attack, and he doesn't have much economy at all. He's got one spine, second one building. Those Lings are also going to be out of position because they're instead going to be looking around the map. Going to pick off this Hellion, probably go towards the natural. I don't think he has any idea that this is coming. This Ling might have spotted some of it. Oh my gosh, that Ling hasn't spotted any of it,
no,
so...
just a bit out, but here we go, the SCV's gonna roll up here. We've got Hellions on the back foot as well, an handful of Marauders just for the hell of it. But that Spinecrawler will probably drop almost instantly. Look at those SCVs go. That's quite funny to see.
Yeah.
But I mean, taking a look at units, mOOnGLade only has 6 Lings to deal with this, and he's making 18 more, so it's plenty, but...
I think that's it.
Oh, wow.
He doesn't have a Bane Nest or anything. One Queen has already dropped to SCVs, the other one's struggling. Glade was expecting Banshees. Wasn't expecting Marauder Hellion with all these SCVs, so I think this will be it for Glade. Nice build from Aegis. I actually saw him practice it against Mafia before I came into this cast. So he's hit with a really good early timing and fooled his opponent, and that's what it's all about. So we'll be able to close out the first game with quite a simple build.
Yeah, and I mean, oh, there we go. GG goes out. So game one goes to Aegis.